Hello and welcome back. My name is Chris Parker with ParkerPhotographic.com and this is chapter 3 of 12 for my free Luminar Neo course. In this Luminar Neo tutorial, we're going to do an overview of the photo editing tools in Luminar Neo. In future tutorials, we'll do a deeper dive into them. If you are ready, let's do it. So let's say you didn't get the perfect composition when you created an image. You can go into the Crop AI tool here and click on this composition button, and then Luminar Neo will analyze your image and try and improve the composition based on its analyzation. Sometimes it will give you a better composition with some images versus others. For example, in this particular image, I would prefer to come in tighter, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Now, just so you know, we're gonna do a quick overview of all the tools here in Luminar Neo. And then later on in the course, we'll go into more detail about each of the individual tools. I'm gonna go ahead and click apply. And as you would expect, Luminar Neo includes some of the basic types of edits that all editing software includes. So if we take a look at the Essentials module here, if we click on Essentials, that will expand to show all the tools inside of it. The first one is the Develop section, where you can adjust your tonal values here for the highlights, shadows, exposure, and then the blacks and the whites. Now, underneath that, you have your tone curve. I love the tone curve. We'll talk more about that later on. And then in color, you can use that to adjust your white balance and some other color options here. You can use this to sharpen your image if you need to remove digital noise. We have noise reduction, and then optics will fix any type of lens distortions. And then transform is more for architecture where that building is maybe leaning a little bit. You can straighten that out with transform. Now, underneath the develop section, we get into some of the AI features that are pretty awesome with Luminar Neo, if you ask me. So enhance will enhance your image. So it's going to add some contrast, some vibrancy to the light in your image and shape that light just a little bit. So with accent, it's going to analyze your image to help that image pop a little bit more, to get those colors and the light and the contrast to be a little bit more vibrant than it is initially. So you can definitely see the transition from original to applying the accent pretty high here. I wouldn't go too far, but somewhere in here, it looks pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and undo that for now. Now I'm gonna go in here to my catalog to get another image. And I think this was the Brant Street Pier that I captured in Burlington, Ontario. And on this day, just so you know, these images are not edited. And if we take a look in the corner here, for some reason I had a little bit of a problem with a lot of dust spots on the sensor. There's a few in here that are pretty light, but they're still there. And there's some over here, there's some in the water. So when I did this in Lightroom initially, it took me quite a while to go in and remove them all. But with the race, all we have to do is come down here and click remove spots. Luminar Neo will analyze the image for those spots and it will remove them quicker than I'm explaining it. And if we go back into the corner here, we can see all those dust spots are gone in that corner. They're gone over here. And there were a couple in the water. There's actually one right here. But we can go in and make adjustments to anything that it didn't find. And I still find that to be 100 times faster than with Lightroom. And then under that, we have another AI tool called Structure. Let's go ahead and zoom out here. And this is going to enhance the details in your image and add a little bit of clarity. So if we increase this to the right, you're gonna see that the image begins to appear to be sharper, and that's because it's applying that crisp clarity to the edge of the details. So again, it's going to use the AI built into the tool to analyze the image to enhance those details. Let's go ahead and undo that. And then we have some color options here. We have saturation, vibrance, and then if you want to remove a color cast, you can actually do that from here. So with one slider, instead of using the white balance tool, this is so much easier. It's going to notice that blue color cast in the shadows there, and it's going to begin warming that up. All right, so that's a pretty cool tool as well. If you want to convert your image into black and white, you can do that. And then you have six different color channels here to customize that particular black and white to whatever it is you want. So you can make certain parts darker or brighter based on the colors that you're targeting. Next, we have details, and this is going to target different size details. So we have small, medium, and large details. And if you want to increase the clarity of those details, you would use these sliders here, and you can also use the sharpen tool. So these small detail sliders are basically going to give the appearance of sharpening your image based on the size of details that you're targeting. Next, if you have digital noise, you can remove that from this panel here. And then we have a landscape section here that is specific for, well, landscapes. So let's go ahead and grab a new image here. This is one of my favorite images from 2022. I shot this at Letchworth State Park in New York, and this was during sunrise. So let's take a look at the landscape options here. If there's some haze in there, you can dehaze that with this. So it's basically adding contrast. And if you shot during the golden hour or sunrise or sunset, you can increase that golden color with the golden hour slider here. And then foliage will enhance those colors in the trees and the grass, etc. Next, we have the vignette option, which will, of course, allow you to add a vignette. Whether you want it brighter or darker, that's entirely up to you. Now, this next section, the creative section, is where Luminar Neo begins to separate itself from other editing software, because it's going to provide tools to make it easier to create some, well, creative type of effects that take a lot longer to do in Lightroom and Photoshop. This first one is a Relight AI tool that will allow you to increase or decrease the brightness of the foreground or the background, and you can change the depth from here. The sky, if you have a plain, boring white sky, you may want to add some white, fluffy clouds into that image instead of what you had previously. Now, for this particular image, these clouds do not fit this particular image because the colors are different in the rest of the scene compared to the sky. So you want to make sure that those clouds match the time of day. So these clouds obviously were shot during the middle of the day versus the sunrise for this particular image. And there's a lot of different options down here that we'll go over later. Now, atmosphere is pretty cool as well. You can add a fog, a mist, or a haze, and that's all based on artificial intelligence as well. Now, sunrays is pretty cool as well if you want to enhance or add sunrays in your image. So we can place a center here, make sure it aligns with where that sunlight is coming from, and then you can add some sunrays. Pretty awesome. So that's something that we could only do in Photoshop before. We can't do it in Lightroom. This is why I said earlier that I think of Luminar Neo to be a hybrid of Photoshop and Lightroom, and this is one of the reasons why. If you want to make your images a little bit more dramatic, you can do that with this slider here, and it kind of gives a grungy effect. Let's get a photo here of my daughter. And if we increase the amount, you can see it kind of takes on a grungy effect. So it's adding contrast and muting those colors a little bit. So something a little bit different, a little bit more creative. And then we have mood. If you want to change the mood of an image, you can do that with these sliders here based on the LUT that you select. So we have some cinematic toning effects. We have some creative options, cross-processing, and then portrait toning from here. Speaking of toning, we have a specific tool for toning. So you can apply some colors in the highlights and shadows from here. Under that, we have what is known as a matte effect. So if you like that old school retro matte type of look, you can get that effect directly with this panel here. And I'm going to show you how to do it with the tone curve as well, but it's a lot quicker with the matte section or the matte module. Next, we have mystical, which will allow you to create something a little bit more mysterious, paranormal, something like that. If you want to increase the amount to your liking, it will then begin blurring those edges of detail to give that ghostly, paranormal type of effect. Now, if you just want a straight up glow, you can do that with this module here. And then if you want to enhance your retro effects based on whatever you've done up here with the other tools, you can add some film grain. So that's pretty cool. All right, let's close off creative. Next, we have some portrait tools. I'm gonna go ahead and select another photo of my daughter here. And we have some AI tools here. So the first one is portrait bokeh, which simply means blurring out the background. So how much of the background do you wanna blur out? Sometimes we don't blur out the background as much as we like, depending on the aperture that we use. Sometimes, depending on the lens that we're using, we have a larger aperture with one lens versus another, and you will get more bokeh with one versus another. So if you're not getting the amount of blur that you want, all you have to do is come in here and adjust this slider here. And of course, you have some other options here to fine tune that bokeh that you're going to add. Face AI and body AI, probably a little controversial based on what you can do with these, but we don't need Photoshop to slim the face or in body to reshape the body. So could be a little controversial depending on what you want to do. If that's what you want to do, that's up to you. You don't need Photoshop for that anymore. Now, skin AI will allow you to begin removing blemishes on the skin and removing shine. Then we have high key, which will allow you to create a high key effect based on that particular photography technique. Then under that, we have some professional tools that are a little bit more advanced and will allow you to customize your edit based on your creative vision. Now, before we go on to other tutorials, let's take a quick look over here on the left side. We have something called layers. Now, these aren't your typical type of layers that you may be used to in Photoshop or other programs that have layers, but the concept is similar. Layers in Luminar Neo simply means once you click on this little icon right here, you're gonna get this pop-up of different overlays. So we have Stardust, Bokeh, we have Sparklers, Light Leaks, and Flares. So if you wanna add a light leak, let's go ahead and take a look inside here. You can see that there's quite a few to choose from. I'm just gonna pick one real quick. It's going to apply that particular overlay as a layer on top of your image. And we'll talk more about this later on as well. All right, so far we've only covered the basics of Luminar Neo and what you can do with it. I've created a free Luminar Neo course for beginners that you can begin watching by clicking on that video next.